Before we came here, we lived with God, our loving Heavenly Father, and His Son, Jesus Christ. We are the literal spirit children of God, and He has a divine plan for our lives. In the beginning, God created light and dark, heaven and earth, land and sea, grass, herb, tree, the fish of the waters and the fowl of the air, and all creatures that move upon the earth. Then God created man in His own image. In the image of God created He him. Male and female created He them, and placed them in a beautiful garden, commanding them to take care of it, to have children, and to find joy therein, but not to partake of the forbidden fruit, lest they would fall and die. Then Satan, an enemy to God's plan, that old serpent, even the devil, came and tempted Eve to partake of the forbidden fruit, and she chose to partake, and Adam with her, and they fell. But because God loves us, He had prepared a plan by which His children could move forward. He sent angels to declare the divine mission of Jesus Christ, that through Christ all would live again and sin and mistakes can be overcome. So Adam taught the gospel to his children, and while some cherished the truth, others rejected, until a widespread rejection led to a falling away. But because God loves us, He restored the truth, lovingly, steadily, through living prophets throughout time, until in the meridian of time, He sent His only begotten Son, who taught the fullness of His gospel, called disciples, and performed miracles, the greatest of which was His atonement and literal resurrection. Then Jesus appeared to His disciples and established a church built upon the foundation of apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ Himself being the chief cornerstone, with the fullness of the knowledge of how to return to God. But even Him they rejected. Authority was lost, and people wandered in a famine from hearing the words of the Lord. But those who honestly sought truth searched the Word of God, and thereby Joseph Smith in the 1820s came to read that if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God. So Joseph asked in faith, and he received a glorious vision whereby God the Father and His Son Jesus Christ appeared. They called Joseph by name, and he was later called to translate the Book of Mormon, another testament of Jesus Christ. And authority was restored, and prophets as an old were divinely appointed in preparation for the second coming of the Savior. The fullness has been restored. The restitution of all things is taking place as a people are preparing for the reign of Christ, a time of no more sorrow, no more death upon the earth, a millennia of light, peace, and joy, where all wrong will be made right, as God shall wipe away tears off all faces. Know that through the gospel of Jesus Christ, all will live again, and that through Him all can live, united as families pure and clean in the presence of God forever. This is why saints in early days and in latter days rejoice that a voice from heaven bore record saying, "This is my beloved Son, hear Him."